Okay, in previous lecture we see already the responsibilities of software project manager. So what are those? So project manager have very difficult responsibilities, and it is very difficult to enumerate the all responsibilities. Beside of that, responsibility of project manager will be truly categorized into three classes. First is a project planning, second is a project controlling, and third one is a project monitoring. Right? So project planning means what? So this project planning activity will be taken place before the development of your project starts. Right? So project planning is done by the project manager before the development activity starts. Then once project planning is done and development process is going on, after that project monitoring and project controlling activity will be taken. So throughout the development of a process, project manager will need to check that whether you are going according to your schedule or not. So if lagging of schedule means what? Customer dissatisfaction will be there, and again indirectly it will discourage or decrease the team morale, right? Team morale. So project manager will have a broad view of activities going through the development process of your project. So again, project monitoring and project controlling means what? Confirmation of whether you are going according to your schedule or not. Again, what it will be, what project manager will give a commitment that you are deliver whether a good quality product or not. Customer satisfaction will value or importance. And again, next is a what? Next is a what? Maintenance of any modification will be taken by the project manager. So according to that, in a project planning, we are describing various attributes for the estimation. So first attribute was the project size, then project cost, then next is a duration of the project, then efforts required to develop the project. Then next estimation attribute will be what hardware and software requirement for the development of project. Then next is what? Next, whatever resources and manpowers are required during the throughout the development of a project, that will again estimate during the project planning. Then next is what? Last one, risk identification will be there. Then next is what? Miscellaneous plans will be there. So in a project planning, these all attributes should be estimated in a planning activity, right? So this cover under the project planning. So in a project planning, which type of attribute have a higher precedence ordering? I already explained you precedence ordering. So there are three important attributes: effort, then what? Size, cost, right? Okay. So size estimation, then cost estimation, effort estimation will have a higher precedence. Among that, size estimation is a higher level precedence attribute in a project planning. So you should estimate, accurate estimation should be there for the size. So again, we are seeing that as sliding window planning. Sliding window planning means what? Now up to this, we see that the project planning is done before the development process starts. Actual developing of process starts. Project manager will do the project planning activity before the development of project. So in a sliding window planning, what happens? Phase-wise planning will be there. Phase-wise planning will be there in a sliding window planning. So phase-wise planning, what will be the advantage of phase-wise planning? So it will protect, project manager will protect to give a big commitment too early. Big commitment too early. So according to that, once phase one, first phase is, development of first phase is over, he will go for the second phase planning. So sliding window planning means what? Like you are in a computer network, sliding window protocol is there, na? Sliding window protocol. So window will be slided. That's like a sliding window planning, in that it will protect to the project manager, like to make a big commit at a too early. And again, project manager will not have a whole idea of your project at a first stage of a planning. So he will do the, so information base will be gradually increased during the development phase of your, mean development life cycle of your project. So after finishing first phase, he will go for the second phase, he will go for the planning for the second phase. Then again, after finishing the second phase, he will go for the third phase planning. So he will not make a big comment in a previous stage to the customer, right? So this is again what? Sliding window planning. Software project management plan, what is that? So whatever project manager will plan for the throughout the software development life cycle, so that will be put in a one document called as the software project management plan document. Okay, so in that again you will have a various attributes in a software project management plan document. Like a objective of your project, some example, like second is a project estimate, schedule, project resources, then staff organization, risk management plan, then project tracking and controlling plan, and miscellaneous plan if you are having with your project, then that will be included in a software project management plan document. Okay. Next important point, metrics for software project size estimation. Metrics for software project size estimation. So in that you will have a basic two metrics. One is a line of code and second is a function point. One is a line of code and second is a function point. So these are two basic size estimation metrics for the software development process. So initially you need to calculate the size, and according to that, whatever efforts required to develop the project, what duration is required to develop the project, and what is the size of your project, depending upon that, project manager will go for the project planning, right? So how to calculate size of your project? Again, first metric is a line of code, second is a function point. So line of code means what? Line of code, how many lines are there in your source code? Okay, so it will not happen that line of code is just the number of bytes that source code have, or the number of bytes in an executable code have. It will be what? Again, eliminate the comment line and header line from your source code. Whatever number of instructions are there, that will be. Now, some may happen that one developer for doing one, suppose print addition of two numbers, print addition of two numbers, this code. So one developer will perform addition in a printf statement within itself. Okay. Then some developer will perform first addition of two numbers and then print the result. So for the same task, different developers will have a different number of lines. So that will be the drawback of a line of a code. Okay. And again, one major drawback is what? In planning itself, you are calculating and you are going for the size estimation metric. So how you will able to identify the exact size of your software? Because right now your development of project is not started yet. You are in a planning stage and you are planned for according to size. So how you will estimate the size, accurate size of your project? So one more option is what? Take a similar project, already developed a similar project, and again, so that will be what? Approximate entry of your size. Whatever you are planning for the size matrix, line of code, that will be not an accurate estimation. That will be the approximate. Why? Because you are calculating line of code and you are in a planning stage. Yet development of your project is not started. So you can't estimate the accurate size, right? So one option is what? Go for the similar project and put a approximate line of code. Second option is what? Divide your whole system in a different module, then one module in a sub-module. Like that, you reach up to the leaf node, the unit, like a unit, and then calculate the unit size and then perform the addition. Again, that will be what? Approximate estimation. You will not get an accurate estimation of a line of code in a planning phase. So this is what a drawback of a line of code. Next is a function point metric. So function point metric, how you will calculate function point? So expression of function point is already told you. Right? How function point matrix gets calculated? Unadjusted function point into technical complexity factor. Unadjusted function point into technical complexity factor. So how you will calculate the unadjusted function point? Number of input into 4 plus number of output into 5 plus number of inquiries plus into 4 plus number of files into 10 plus number of interfaces, okay, into 10. So unadjusted function point. Now what is mean by function point metric? Take one system like you are taking an input from a user, then process that input and give the output. Like suppose a library management system. In library management system, you are taking a name of book from user and then you will give a user that how many books are available and location of book. Right? So this in a library management system, book name will be input and location and number of copies of book will be the output. So in that case, input and output. Now listen, input means whatever data. Now you should distinguish between the input and inquiries. Input and inquiries. Like suppose print a balance statement will be the inquiry. And withdraw this amount from my account. So what amount user enters, that will be the input. Right? So you should distinguish between the input and inquiries first. Okay. Now number of input means individual input entry you should not take for your software. Related data to the input will be considered as a one input. Consider example of an employee. So one employee will have his name, age, date of birth. These attributes will be there. So all these data will be associated with the one employee. So that employee data you are considered as a one input. Are you getting? Input means related data will be considered as a one input. So number of input into 4, then number of output into 5, number of inquiries into 4. Now number of inquiries you already know. Inquiry means suppose print balance. Now inquiry means what? Such a user's command, system will respond you. System will respond you. So number of inquiries plus number of files. Number of files means what? Whatever physical files or logical files you are using for your project, that will be considered under the number of files. So in that case, logical file may be you are using any type of a data structure for your project. So that will be considered under the logical file. Physical files means actual files you are using. Okay. Next, number of interfaces. Number of interfaces means what? Suppose you are taking a data from a tape drive. So that will be what you need to interface that tape drive with your system. Then database if you are using. Then again suppose your system is connected into the another system. So that another system will be considered as a interface. Okay, so number of interface that you are using for your project. So according to that unadjusted function point will be calculated. Next is what technical complexity factor. So technical complexity factor, how you will calculate technical complexity factor? Plus 0.01 into DI. DI is what? Degree of influence. DI is a degree of influence. So degree of influence will be what? Degree of influence. There are total 14 attributes such as a suppose response time, then throughput. According to that, now whatever now you may you will not use suppose all the 14 attributes for your project. If you are using 6 attributes, 7 attributes, so according to that, what attribute will have a what influence already defined. Suppose you need to give the influence from 0 means what? That influence is absent, or 0 influence, 6 is what? High influence. That attribute is a present and which have a high influence. So that degree of influence will be belongs to 0 to 6. And 14 attributes are there for the degree of influence. So summation of all the attributes. Now first suppose you are considering throughput for your project. And that throughput attribute, you are saying that degree of influence is a 4. Plus suppose response time you are taking as an attribute. Degree of influence is suppose you are deciding 3. Who will decide this 14 attributes? From 14 attributes, what type of attribute for your project, and each attribute will have a what degree of influence, that will be decided by project manager in a project planning within itself. So suppose he give the number throughput as a 4, then response time is a 3, then like that, how many attributes you are having for your project, make a summation of that, it will calculate as a degree of influence. Degree of influence. So this degree of influence may be depending upon all 14 attributes. Suppose all 14 attributes are absent, degree of influence will be 0 to 70. Maximum is a 70. So depending upon degree of influence, your technical complexity factor will be 0.65 to 1.35. According to that, function point, function means what? Function point metric means what? Every system will perform different number of functions. Every system. So whatever project you are going to develop, how many functions or how many processes in your project, so project manager will decide that. Then again, depending upon that, how many functions are there in your project and what function point matrix give estimation. According to that, summation of all function points will be calculated and size of your whole project will get calculated. Are you getting? So there are two size matrix for the project planning, line of code and the function point. Any doubt in this two matrix, size matrix? Got it? Okay, so we will go for the next concept, COCOMO model. Any doubt? Silence means everything is understood or nothing is understood. Huh? Two conclusions. So which scientist decide this line of code and function point matrix? Huh? Name of scientist. In previous lecture, I think I told you name of scientist. Albrecht. Huh? So before going to COCOMO model is what a constructive cost estimation model. Now see, we see in the two matrix for the calculation. Like, so according to basic matrix, on the basis of that, you will go for the cost estimation of whole project. Right. What efforts your software requires, then what duration of development, then size of your software. Depending on all these attributes or metrics, you are going to calculate the cost. You are going to estimate the cost. Okay. So before going to COCOMO model, we will see first organic, second semi-detached, and third . So depending upon development complexity, every software project is classified under these three types. So you need to clarify first before going for the project planning, what type of project you are going to develop, whether organic project is there or whether semi-detached project or the embedded. So depending upon development complexity, there are three categories. So who decide these three categories? Scientist named Boehm in 1981. He makes the classification of project. First category is organic, second is a semi-detached, third is a embedded. Okay. So organic means what? Semi-detached means what? Any guess? Hmm? Normally, data processing programs are, you are treated as an application program you are developing. So that will come under the organic classification. Second, suppose you are dealing with the compiler, linker, that is utility programs are there. So that utility programs will be come under the semi-detached classification. And third is the embedded means what? If you are directly dealing with the system program or the operating system, then that will come under the embedded software. Okay. If you are dealing with the hardware, it will come under the embedded software. Write down. Write down first organic. If the project deals with developing a well understood application program, comma, the size of development team is reasonably small, and the team members are experienced in developing similar types of projects. So organic means what? Normally data processing is called as the application program. And again, team size is a small, and again, team have a experienced staff member. So this differentiation is again very important for the organic. So in organic classification, team members should be experienced, and again, team size will be small, and data processing or application programs are come under the organic. Second, semi-detached. If the development consists of a mixture of experienced and inexperienced staff, team members may have limited experience. On related systems, but may be unfamiliar with some aspects of the system being developed. So in a semi-detached category, compiler, linkers, like a utility programs will come under this, and again may have a team, unexperienced team members, experienced team members, it will be mixture of both, and maybe any team member have a experience but unfamiliar with the system that they are going to develop. Next category is embedded. If the software being developed is strongly coupled to complex hardware or If the stringent regulations on the operational procedures exist. So in this word, operating system or system programming will come under the embedded software category. Okay. So we'll go for the COCOMO model. COCOMO, long form of COCOMO is constructive cost estimation model. Means what? By using COCOMO model, we can estimate the cost of your project. So in that, you are having three types of COCOMO model: basic COCOMO, intermediate COCOMO, and third one is a complete COCOMO. So this constructive cost estimation model will give you the approximate cost of your software. So in that, write down expression: effort is equal to A1 into K log raised to A2 PM. Second, T dev, that is time for development, B1 into effort raised to B2 month. So basic COCOMO model have a this expression to estimate, approximate word is very important. You are not going to estimate accurate cost of your project, approximation cost, and which is expressed by in terms of effort and development time. So effort is equal to A1 into K log raised to A2 PM. Write down K log means K log is the estimated size of the software product. KLOC is the estimated size of the software product expressed in kilo lines of code. Kilo lines of code. Next, A1, A2, B1, B2 are constants. A1, A2, B1, B2 are constants for each category of software product. For each category of software product. Next, TDEV. TDEV is the estimated time to develop the software, expressed in months. Develop the software expressed in months. Last, effort is the total effort required to develop the software product expressed in person month, capital PM, person month, not a prime minister, person month, PM. So first is what? Kilolock is a line of code calculate in a kilo, but line of code, how you are going to calculate? Every line will be treated as a one. Suppose at a single line, number of instructions are written by developer. That will be again considered as only single line, one line. Okay. It will not calculate that on a one line, how many instructions. Forget about that. Every line of code is counted as a one. So that will be what? Line of code. A1, A2, B1, B2. These are the values decided by this scientist, depending upon different categories of your project, and that will be again what decided by a historical, by using the historical project, and then A1, A2, B1, B2, these constants are decided according to the categories of project. Next is what? A person month. Person month means what? Person month, it is not like that 100 PM means 100 persons are worked in a 1 month, or 100 one person as an employee is allocated during the 100 months. It is not like that. 100 PM means it will be graph. Take down that graph. So on a x-axis and y-axis, number of persons working on a project, total number of persons working on a project, and this one is a time duration. Suppose your graph is like that. So person month is denote the area. This area will be treated as a person month. Means 100 PM means what? 100 PM will be decided as a this area. Not a 100 employees are employed at a 1 month for the development, or a one employee is allocated to up to the 100 months. It is not a like that. 100 PM is a area under which number of persons and time. Number of persons allocated to the development process and estimated time for the duration. Means duration of your development. Okay. Next. So predefined values. Take down. Predefined values. Predefined values for the organic for the organic effort is equal to 2.4 k log raised to 1.05 pm. These are predefined values of effort decided by scientist Boehm for the organic category of project. So effort is equal to 2.4 into k log raised to 1.05. So in that case, value is this value b1 is 2.4 and b2 is 1.05, like that. Sorry, A1, A2. Okay. Next, semi-detached effort is equal to 3.0 into k log raised to 1.12 pm. For the embedded effort is equal to 3.6 k log raised to 1.20 person month. So these are the estimate of development effort. Next, development time, estimation of development time. First, for the organic, Tdev is equal to 2.5 into effort raised to 0.38 months. So in that case, value of B1 will be 2.5, B2 will be 0.38. For the second category, Tdev is equal to 2.5 into effort raised to 0.35 months. Then for the third category, Tdev is equal to 2.5 effort raised to 0.32 months. Let's finish. Take example. Assume that the size of an organic type software product, has been estimated $15,000 per month Assume that the average salary of software engineer be 15,000 per month. Full stop. Determine the effort required to develop the software product. Determine the effort required to develop the software product and the nominal development time. And the nominal development time. Development time. Also calculate cost. Also calculate cost. Read the problem statement and try to solve. What is the answer? Effort. Effort. I say you need to put a value in an expression within itself and calculate. Category of project is organic. So you need to select this effort and this development time. Cost or effort? Effort. How much? 58,000. How? A4C 2.4 into source code they are giving 32,000. So kilo line of code. So 32. Raised to 1.05, you will get answer of effort. 91. The next development time 2.5. 91 raised to 0.38. How much? 14 months. Then cost, final cost, 14 into salary of average salary of engineer 15,000. How much? 2,10,000.